The sound of the ocean, a calming, enveloping and safe sound, a sound symbol, the sound of the uterus, the predictable yet changing rhythms that synchronizes your body in resonance with nature.
My name is Sandra Kopler. I'm an architect working at the Department of Architecture and Built Environment at Lund University. When we got the question to do a piece for the sound bench, we came to think of places of relaxation, of sitting, taking a break. And natural environments are typically seen as such spaces. However, lately, natural environments are also invited by an association to climate change. And the sound of water may evoke feelings of a break, of it may trigger recovery, but it may also make you think of a rising sea level across the globe. So in this way, the listening also deals with fluctuating emotions and an oscillation of scales, an immediate and local scale of sitting on a bench, perhaps remembering the sea, and a global scale of a rising sea level across the globe, as well as pinpointing a contrast between the private and the collective experience and responsibility.
My name is Marie Højlund. I'm a sound artist and a composer, and also an assistant professor in sound studies at Aarhus University in Denmark. Our piece, Wave, Exploring Sound, Solastalgia, explores sound in relation to solastalgia. Solastalgia is termed by Glen Albrecht in 2005, and it catches this effect of eco-anxiety that is induced in us through climate change or the climate crisis. This sense of loss of comfort in the familiar world, our home, and a form of homesickness without exile is very symptomatic of our experience of the contemporary and sensible world. And we wanted to explore this in relation to familiar and calming sounds, the sound of birds chirping, but also the sound of waves and the ocean, which we normally see or hear as calming. And in many ways, we could say that at least for me and Sandra, these sounds has also changed their meaning the last 10 years or so. And therefore, we wanted to show or to make these changes heard through the sound piece. And in this way, we want to challenge the calming sound of noise of the ocean, and also show how it's also considered to be a dangerous and destabilizing force. And therefore, if you listen to the sound piece and you think that the speakers are broken, we can say that they are not broken. It's just the piece that we composed and that we wanted to actually shake the bench a bit.
A world, he argues, that we experience as exhabitants, not inhabitants. We feel responsible for this environment, but the global worldview represented in models is not a world where we feel we belong and can act. Thus, dominant tendency of simply sharing.